Workman's relief for whatever the job throws at you, like THC products derived from legal hemp. These are legit delicious. Free shipping with products over $75. Order yours at workmansrelief.com for whatever the job throws at you.
This is the JJO Morning Show podcast with Johnny and Dee. Listen, rate, subscribe.
It is friggin' National Hot Dog Day. I feel like we've been hot dog heavy on this show lately with July 4th and everything, but
hot dog, hot dog, hot diggity dog. Now we got ears and five horse ears. Hot dog, hot dog, no problem solved.
Gotcha.
Hot dog, hot dog, hot diggity dog.
Great song.
I know. Stuck in your head.
It's a great song.
Okay, so a recent poll showed that most people have a relatively classic taste when it comes to topping that hot dog. 73% of Americans like some mustard on the hot dog.
Oh, yeah.
Huge fan of the
mustard.
Yeah,
so one time I do enjoy the mustard.
62% like ketchup, and then onions, relish, and chili all got at least 50%.
Mm.
I'll take all that.
Mm-hmm.
I know you avoid the onion at the golf course or anywhere outdoors.
Never eat a warm onion.
Yeah.
You'll go toxic shock. Your body will shut down.
Yeah, you had a bad...
I lost a leg.
Mm-hmm.
At the golf outing there, eating a warm room temperature onion. Yeah, they had to take the leg. I took my leg.
Terrible, terrible time for everybody, really.
So weird, a greenskeeper hacking my leg off with a bandsaw. It was really weird. Like, is there a doctor? Are you...
I always knew this is how it would go down. Anyway, ballpark brand hot dog celebrating freedom of expression by challenging hot dog lovers to post their unique hot dog toppings.
Oh. Ooh.
So we got some weird ones. Are you ready for this?
Yeah, I'm ready for anything. Here you go.
Ranch dressing, no.
Mm. As a last resort, maybe. If I'm on a desert island. You've got a gun to my head.
Jalapeno cream cheese and black bean salsa.
Okay. Sorry.
Fried egg, arugula, guacamole, and garlic aioli.
A fried egg on a hot dog?
I know.
I've never even considered the disaster that would look like. I guess. Somewhat beef and a egg, I guess. All beef hot dog?
I guess.
All right. I mean, they put it on a hamburger for a breakfast burger, I guess. Or, no, they call it the hangover burger, I think.
Right.
Yeah.
So you're just swapping out.
Yeah. You might as well throw some hash browns and bacon and a pancake on it at that point.
Mashed potatoes, gravy, and onions. Stop it.
That sounds like a mess.
You people, stop it.
I mean, I get it.
Right.
But that sounds like a mess.
Cheese, marinara, basil, and pepperoni on your hot dog.
No, not the pepperoni.
Celery and blue cheese.
Okay.
I guess I would throw some onion on there, maybe.
These are all last.
And remember, these are supposed to be like crazy hot dog toppings. Yeah. All right, here we go. This is one I could totally see, and I could see you embracing it because Doritos, pulled pork, barbecue sauce, and bacon on top of your hot dog.
That sounds amazing on anything.
Right. 100%.
That sounds... They ought to put that in a jar and just sell it. They ought to shoot that out of a hose right into my mouth.
God, you put an onion ring on top of that, it's all over,
just
dude.
Cover my house with it. Just bury me in... Wow, that sounds good. What? Say it again. Bacon...
Doritos, pulled pork, barbecue sauce, and bacon.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
Sure.
I never
knew anything could sound that random and that appetizing.
God dang.
That's incredible. Doritos on things is so... we've proven it. I don't even have to say it.
For real.
Dorito in any shape, form, size, serving, fine.
Well, and how nice to have that crunch in there, dude.
I'm surprised we haven't made a Dorito cereal yet. Dorito.
It's only a matter of time.
What do we call that? Doritos. I got to think about it for a minute.
Yeah, take your time.
Anyways, trying to think of Dorito berries. No, Dorito. No. Dorito flakes. Dorito flakes. Cheese covered flakes. I don't know.
It'd be like little tiny Doritos.
Yeah, that would be funny, wouldn't it? Little holes in them.
And you know the food manufacturers would somehow still be like,
how about
it's a good way to start your day.
How about Cheritos? We'll combine two of them.
Yeah, why not? Jesus.
What if you took a Cheerio and just covered in Dorito dust?
God.
And then just meet you halfway.
Why not? Why not?
My favorite, if you want to tell us where you go get a hot dog, my go-to hot dog, it's not just because it's near my house, but it's A&W.
Oh, yeah. I haven't had one there.
Coney Island, whether you get it covered in cheese sauce or not, it's incredible. Their chili sauce is phenomenal. And I don't even know what kind of hot dog. I know they're beef, but they're amazing. The bun is nice and it's just really well done. I don't know.
Black Bear. That was the last time I got a hot dog out. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and then the last time I was at a cookout, I had a brat, not a hot dog. So it's been a while. I feel bad. I feel like I'm abandoning my hot dog roots.
Stop at Quick Trip, get a $1.50 dog, and roll on.
Oh, yeah, the roller dog.
Just roll on. Mm-hmm. Just keep rolling.
Nothing like that roller dog.
Well, that's another good hot dog I've had.
Man, oh, man. I might have to have some hot dogs for dinner.
Doesn't sound good on a grill.
God.
That does sound good today. Stop and grab a pack of dogs. Get some weird hot dogs. Let me see some weird hot dog brands that I haven't tried.
I'm going to fast and do that pulled pork barbecue sauce bacon Doritos dog. Jesus Christ.
I might try that.
Incredible.
I might actually try that. Most popular brand of hot dog.
That sounds like something that the Vintage would have.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
With like a onion jam or something
just,
on there.
You could just put it on nachos and just cut hot dog pieces on it. Throw it on top.
Why not?
Wouldn't that sound cool and kind of like a rice bowl with hot dogs?
Oh, Lord.
Just chock full of.
And we're just like being honest. There's nothing healthy about this.
God, with a big cold beer. Oh, man, does that sound good.
Yep.
That's a good one.
People, relax.
What a complete waste.
We are killing it online. Have you guys checked the comments?
Of cyberspace.
Smoke That Skin Wagon says, you guys are killing it.
The JJO Morning Show Podcast.
We're internet sensations.
Workman's Relief for whatever the job throws at you. Like THC products derived from legal hemp. These are legit delicious. Free shipping with products over $75. Order yours at workmansrelief.com. For whatever the job throws at you.
Johnny and D, nowhere but JJO.
Do we want to go over the Star Spangled Banner now?
Is there a good time to go over the Star Spangled
right,
Banner?
I know.
I don't know.
I mean, I feel like we're all scarred, right?
Hang on.
You called it yesterday. I mean, I feel like you're undefeated, right?
She drunk.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ingrid says she's drunk. She's got to go to rehab. She is not going to bullshit any of us.
Wake up call, dude. The country is unhappy. I don't know what your other... That's the only move you had, really. I mean, a checkmate. Get your ass to rehab and blame somebody else.
I don't know.
Blame Jack Daniels. It's always Jack's fault.
You could just say, I suck. I don't know.
She was... When we met her backstage, she was drinking wine.
Oh.
Yeah, so.
What kind of wine?
But she seemed, functioning.
Red wine?
I don't even remember.
White wine?
Yeah, I don't remember.
Was it a spritzer?
This is more than a spritzer.
I'm not going to bullshit y'all. I was drunk last night. I'm checking myself into a facility today to get the help I need. That was not me last night. I apologize to MLB, all the fans in this country I love so much. For that rendition, I'll let y'all know how rehab is. I hear it's super fun.
Made me laugh.
Bam, 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 bam.
That made me laugh.
People calling her out in the comments for sure, but whatever.
We should go to a karaoke bar and try it some night in front of people, see how we do.
I know how we would do, which is why
we might do it better. We might not hit those howling, screeches.
I do have a montage.
Yeah.
Terrible.
There you go.
Terrible Star Spangled Banners. Here we go.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light?
Once so proudly.
Aaron Lewis, by the way.
We hailed. We're so gallantly streaming.
And the Rockets. Uh oh.
make up for it now.
Let a flag wash there.
My girl. Love you, Fergie.
For the land of the free.
Out of sync with the organ.
Yeah.
Polish and live in Pittsburgh, you can do anything you want with the words.
Wow, what a great line that is. Random.
Right?
But I hope that dude was Polish. Or it's going to be...
Was cancel culture a thing then?
Punched right in the nose.
Ingrid. I don't know. Was it that big of a deal? Were people mad at her? Whatever. Everything's a big deal, I guess, for 24 hours.
Yeah. Yeah, it feels like it was almost more than booze. I've seen people in bars drunk that I think have a basic grasp of singing.
Right.
That don't sound as bad as she did. And I don't know, because parts of it, she didn't sound drunk.
Right.
And other parts, it was like, whoa, where did she come from? So lack of focus, the high parts. Maybe she drank because she wasn't confident singing it in the first place. I'll drink some wine. It'll take the edge off. You know how people get when they socialize. They need cocktails.
I don't know. If her concerts are doing fine and she's showing up to things.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. Are you not allowed to have a screw up every now and then?
Or is there trickery on stage when she does a show?
Is there smoke and mirrors? Is there some sort of
a little Milli Vanilli scandal?
Assistance there?
Yeah, I mean, it does make you think. It ruins it for everything. Is she actually the real vocalist on stage, or does somebody sing for her? I know she writes a lot of songs for people. You know. Maybe I should be the one to do it. Maybe I should write a song called I Was Hammered When I Sang the Star Spangled Banner. Just call the song that.
Star Spangled Hammered.
Star Spangled Hammered by Ingrid. Star Spangled Hammered.
Mm-hmm.
Just sing a song about how you did, how you bombed out at the batting competition.
Yeah.
The home run derby.
I mean,
Star Spangled Hammered. I'll write that.
If she indeed has a problem, good for her.
Should I set it to the words of the same song? Star Spangled
Hammered. Let a flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star spangled banner?
She didn't apologize. Fergie was like, that's what you get.
Mm-hmm. Ooh.
Play ball. Yeah. Well.
I don't know if she got caught. And many people have. I don't know. A lot of people don't have.
I didn't think it was that big of a deal.
It's less a big a deal now than it was yesterday. I don't know why it's happening. You watch it, and you just do you feel bad for the person?
Yes.
It's like, but you're a professional. You make so much money. How do you sing like that?
Vince Neil.
And maybe you can't hear yourself. Maybe your monitors went out. Maybe you hear the echo or something. I don't know.
Sure.
I don't know anything about it.
100%.
I don't know. All I know is when I hear a bad one.
Right. Exactly. 100%.
And I don't even know if her voice is all that great to begin with. I mean, talented girl. She's got her own records. And I don't know if she's the best vocalist ever. So I don't know, dude. I know a lot of people don't know who she was, but they know now. And I don't think rehab is supposed to be super fun, but.
Yeah, that.
In a weird statement.
Wasn't exactly the greatest thing to say, but whatever.
She was drunk again when she made the statement after she was drunk singing
kind
the song.
Kind of a, yeah. But. However you have to deal with it, sister. And
it would be interesting if you were a nobody and it kind of launched a career.
Right.
That I could see that being a thing for somebody. Viral, the viral moments in life. But to have somebody established go out and bomb, I think people enjoy the disaster.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, that's where we are, yeah. Man. People love, it makes you feel better telling Bimbo she can't sing.
There's no denying that. You cannot deny that.
You know?
When I watch it, God, it's just so uncomfortable. And it's just like, oh, you're almost done. It's almost over. Like, oh, you're so close to being done. It's just squeeze it out. Come on. You know?
But where's the vetting process? It's like, okay, you have to. We're going to make you sing this three times in front of our panel of judges.
But like I said, I have friends that have sang it, and they will do it. They've done it thousands of times, and then they'll freeze.
See, the other part is when you're drunk, you forget words.
Sure.
Classic drunk.
But you also do that sober. You know, like sometimes your brain just like.
Almost like vodka. I bet she was on vodka. That's vodka. You forget. That's the blackout cocktail.
Okay.
Any vodka. Martinis. Try drinking five of those at lunch.
Oh, my God. Nobody drinks five martinis.
Yes, they do.
Well, you do.
Well, is that why I was in the parking lot at Liberty Station singing the Star Spangled Banner?
Yeah.
Oh, that's why I was arrested.
It's the reason why they call it a two martini lunch.
Oh.
It's supposed to be two. Because after three, it gets real bad.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Well, maybe she'll sober up and get another shot at it. I don't know.
I don't know either.
It's not going to end her career because in country, look at Morgan Wallen threw a chair off the top of Eric Church's bar and sold another 10 million album. So I don't think in that genre, being hammered stunts your career.
Yeah.
A lot of guys get DUIs down there. A lot of men and women in country music get DUIs, and it just builds their reputation a little bit.
Yeah. And if she does have a problem, good for her for seeking help. I just hope it's not like,
you know,
this is my excuse for having a crappy performance. Because you know what? You're allowed to have a bad day at work. You really are.
You know, I was having a cocktail the other night when I was watching that. I guess if you're having a cocktail, you can't judge the lady that had too many cocktails.
Right.
I was drinking a beer. I was drinking my jalapeno beer from Uga Brewing Company.
Yeah.
So I ain't even got a cat in the fight. Let he who is barely sober judge first.
Well, like I said, her crappy rendition is still better than any rendition I could do.
Oh, 100%.
But
like I said, you just know when it's bad. You just know when it's bad. It's just cringy.
Mm-hmm. And we're willing to give grace to those local talents and those kids that come out and sing it and screw it up. You know, we'll give them a free pass.
Right.
But
isn't it worse if Roseanne Barr, who comes out knowingly effing it up?
Well, I feel like that was different because that felt like.
It's what she does.
Intent.
Yeah. Like, totally.
She meant for that to be disrespectful.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. And that's why I think these versions, when somebody that does it for a living, it's more shocking. It has more effect on people. But I don't know. So you're supposed to be a pro.
A little bit of damage control happening.
They'll rally around her. I mean, you know, it's just a song. How bad can it be?
People's attention spans be real short.
How bad can it be?
You know, but I also feel like people are looking for a distraction now. So, but yeah, that Fergie version is starting to look real good.
She probably won't even go to rehab.
She's going to go on a boat.
She's going to go on a boat.
She's on vacation right now.
She gets the drink package. Those come in pretty handy.
She's hitting the beach, dude.
Will she go to rehab? There's a good question. I'm guessing that's a PR statement.
It's a weird one, though. It's a weird card to play, don't you think?
I'm 30. I'm going to rehab because it's fun.
It's a weird card to play because if you don't have a problem, doesn't she have, she has songs about drinking, doesn't she?
Yeah, yeah. I'll go back and listen to her. I'll see if she sounds drunk most of the time.
If she doesn't have a drinking problem or a substance abuse problem and she goes to rehab and then she comes out, like now you can't be drinking in public now. That's going to be a bad look.
Think about it. If you're her and you need an out, though, is it easier to say I was drunk than I'm not a good singer? Then it's like I have help when I'm on a stage.
Why can't you just say I had a bad night?
Because if you don't say you're drunk or you took a sleeping pill or what an allergy or whatever the hell the excuse is, that kind of interferes with your career a little bit.
Right.
So I think that's better than saying, okay, yeah, I actually am not a very good singer. But I don't know. I mean, she's still got to get through shows. So I don't know. Is she getting help? I don't know.
Man.
Or is she just so drunk all the time that you're just willing to roll the dice and go on national TV?
I don't know, dude, but my F's to give have run right out. Totally out right now.
I mean, if it's true, if all of this is true, this is a sad, rock bottom moment we just witnessed.
Well, if singing the national anthem poorly is your rock bottom moment, that's not too bad. You know, it could have been given a blowy at a truck stop for crack money, you know? I mean, come on now.
Right, right, right. Well, pride, I guess. And hey, $20 is $20. What can I say?
That's right.
All right. We're, let me take a call. I'm sure it'll be intelligent. Yes. Hey, I will say this. I wasn't that interested in the home run derby because I go to baseball games. I go to a Brewer game. It's fine. Yelich was popping around last night. He did fine. Baseball, not that interesting to me as a whole, but I like to go and drink.
Yeah.
It did make the home run derby interesting to me.
Well, that was so funny because yesterday I was sitting there thinking, I was like, I have no idea what happened the rest of the home run derby. Does anybody know what happened?
No, nobody knows who won.
Like, we know what happened at the beginning.
Right, right.
And that's it.
Right.
Like, I heard nothing else about the home run derby.
I didn't either. I have no idea who won. I had no idea who any of those guys are. I didn't see a Brewer, so I checked out.
I don't know. It does seem like... So we got a text in that says, like, I feel like it's a PR stunt. Why would you make a joke about it? When I started my recovery, it definitely wasn't a joke. And that's one thing, too, like her post about going into rehab. This just feels like, it feels like bad handling all the way around. If she was drunk before going out to sing the Star Spangled Banner, that's bad management in and of itself.
Right. 100%.
Like, you can't.
Because that's a career moment. It's millions of eyeballs.
Right.
That's a career. That changes careers.
Like your assistant isn't like, hey, you need to hold off till you get done with this.
That's like a promo to get your ass in the running for a Super Bowl gig.
Right.
Right.
Totally. And then the post afterwards, you didn't have somebody approving that post before you put it on Insta either. Like, this just seemed, whatever. But what do I know?
She is in country. They are supposed to be drunk all the time. If you listen to country songs, they're drunk all day. And now we get mad because she's drunk all day?
You got a point.
Dude, that's my story. I'm sticking to it. I hope she doesn't sing at the rehab. Scare the hell out of everybody.
They're like, we'll let you in here, but you cannot sing. It's one condition.
I was trying to think of a country singer that has to be kind of like chaperone. Well, Morgan, I guess. But he's his own dude. He likes to booze it up. I'm trying to think of like the old drunk guys. If the allure of that's kind of going away.
Well,
the legends of the George Jones and the Johnnies and the, you know.
Yeah. Well, because it used to be like rock and roll artists, but most of our artists are sober.
They're bicycling around Lake Mendota before they come in here to sing a sound lounge.
Yeah, they're pretty healthy people.
Like, when did you do that? 4 o'clock this morning.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So now it's the it's the country people.
This is the last country dude that got blind hammered drunk and did something stupid. I don't know. Morgan Wallen? I was trying to think of a bad one. Something on that level. I mean, that could have killed somebody. That could have been bad.
Yeah, for sure.
But I don't think they do it anymore. I don't think they do it that much anymore.
Well, there's so much money in play there that, yeah, I feel like they're getting handled with a very short leash.
I saw an interview with Nancy Wilson from Heart, and she goes, I was the most casual, non-offensive drunk. But she goes, I was drunk all the time. She goes, I had a glass of wine in my hand every day. And I didn't even realize it.
No.
I just walk around with a buzz all day. She goes, I just finally, she's not well right now, but
yeah.
Who knows? And I guess you get into that routine so much that it's just, you don't even notice it. You know, you go on these 2-year long tours and.
Yeah, but that touring ain't easy on your body.
No.
So I don't even know how you.
Right. You
could drink doing that.
I don't know. You cope with the boredom and the day in, day out of the same exact thing. I don't know. It's weird to us because it looks glamorous, but, you know, you listen to those guys and they're like, whoa, this ain't easy.
We thought uploading to the cloud was something completely different.
Come on, Watery.
The JJO Morning Show Podcast. Johnny and D, JJO.
Oh, God.
Styles
back. See, that's it.
Somehow it aged well.
Fergie. Oh,
good. Oh,
see, so there, in a nutshell, you just made a perfect case of why that song gets screwed up so much. Because it's people like her and Ingrid, they try to use their own show off their own voice by taking it down a road that doesn't work.
Yeah, Fergie tried to make it like jazzy.
Yes,
I'm not really sure
exactly
what Ingrid was doing.
And it's not that easy to sing anyways.
Right.
So it's like, well, I can do this. This song is about me now. It's not about the song. It's about me and how I sing.
Somehow,
and that's what screws it up.
Ingrid made me like Fergie's version. I don't know what happened.
So Ingrid made you like Fergie's version?
Yeah.
Oh. So it's just aging well with you.
Yeah.
Are you a Fergie fan?
Oh, yeah. I'm Fergilicious.
Oh, forgot. Thanks for reminding me.
Yeah.
I forgot.
How could you forget?
Jeez. You're just reeking of Fergilicious over there. Wow.
All right. Cops in California have caught a pair of hugging bandits, which is considerably different than kissing bandits, which we have dealt with before. Sharon Bear is a kissing bandit.
Oh, God. She was tonguing everybody in Las Vegas at a sound lounge, and she was quickly dubbed the kissing bandit. Greg was too drunk. He didn't know what was going on.
No idea what was happening.
Whatever, man.
PC2. All he knew was dinner was at 8 p.m., and that was far too late.
Right, and he stayed awake till 8:15, and Sharon went off kissing into the night.
Oh, no. So the hugging bandits would run up to strangers, give them a hug, and pickpocket them, basically. So here is the sergeant talking about the issue.
It's a distractionary burglary is what it is. They're coming up with new methods now. And one of those methods is offering a hug to somebody or acting like they know you and giving you a hug. And while they're giving you that hug, they're targeting a piece of your property.
So it's almost like the lost art of pickpocketing. Mm-hmm. So now you hug. There's your distraction.
Right.
Interesting.
It is interesting because you do see, like, in the TikTok and Reels world, you'll see people with the signs, you know, whatever.
Hug me.
Yeah, totally.
So it's now hugging is not even worth it. You can't even hug somebody without a crime happening.
Yep.
This probably started in California, I'm guessing. Where is this?
California.
Is it all California?
Very good. Yep.
Don't hug. Well, you don't hug strangers. Do you?
Usually, no. I'll hug like listeners and stuff.
Yeah, after a few cocktails.
You know? Or like if people, I don't know, like people share like a pretty personal story, I always want to like hug them. Yeah. But I always ask, like you ask for consent because you never know.
Mm-hmm.
Someone's on the TISM scale.
Don't.
I feel like everybody's on the TISM scale, but.
That's why I carry my 380. You get a little huggy with me, I'm going to shoot you in the balls.
Is that a gun in your pocket?
Yeah. Can you feel it? That's cold steel.
Jesus Christ.
I don't know. Should I just not go out to the market anymore?
Well, I guess just be aware of what you have on you.
Maybe
as
not
a person.
Wear a Rolex, anything fancy. Anything fancy.
Yeah, I don't think anyone's going after that clock on your wrist, you know? You're gigantic.
No, I clock you with this thing. You'll never hug somebody else.
Okay. A pickpocket could not get away with your watch.
That part of the brain that makes you want to hug people, or do bad things. I know where it is. I'm going to hit you with this watch.
But even like, do you have a wallet chain? Do you use a wallet chain?
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know. You just got to be aware. That's all.
Why I don't carry cash.
It's nice though, like your cards and stuff. It's so easy to lock them out now. Well, like it used to be like you had to cancel, but now most of them have a lock option. So if you're missing your card and you don't know where it's at, you can lock it until you find it instead of just having to report it gone and then have to get a new one right away.
I feel like this has been something that's been as old as, you know, it's been going on forever.
Sure.
You know, and now it's a thing again.
Yeah.
Why is it a thing again?
It's just any opportunity, I suppose, that the criminals find. So now it's the whole, oh, hey, dude, good to see you. I haven't seen you in a long time.
Well,
run up to give you a hug.
I have this, like, this natural defense if somebody gets too close.
Yeah.
You know, I don't know. I mean, if you were just walking down the street and somebody came up to give you a hug, what would your response be?
Oh, I'd back up.
I mean, if you weren't having a conversation, somebody just came up, said, hey, man, can't we all get along and then give you a hug?
Be like, no, we can't, actually.
No,
that's
my
not how any of this
first
works.
Defense would be to get some hands up.
Yeah. Oh, 100%. Both hands go up for sure. And you back up. Yep.
What a lousy world.
Timeline sucks right now.
Yeah, don't hug strangers. I mean, isn't that what they teach us since you're, you know, wee high?
Yeah.
Don't talk to strangers. Don't talk to strangers. Baby, don't you talk. Yeah, try not to hug your future robber. I don't know. I don't know what to tell you, buddy.
Well.
If something feels funny, throat punch.
I don't have enough jewelry expensive enough for you to steal.
Mm-hmm.
That's the first thing.
Yeah.
Secondly, you want to take my debit card, you go right ahead. Have fun getting the $10 worth of chips before the damn card gets denied, you know?
There's some video of Fort Lauderdale. You have to look it up. These people are out in the street pretending like they're hurt or abandoned and trying to jack cars.
No.
Yeah, watch it. It just popped this morning. I just saw it. These people just out in the intersection, just out in the car, just trying to randomly jack people.
Yeah. So I guess you have to stay in your car and call 911
right.
for other people.
Right. While they're smashing in your windshield.
That's terrible. That's terrible.
Yeah, I do.
And then if you're a first responder, you know, your first instinct is going to be to get out and help them.
Mm-hmm.
God dang.
And then if somebody is robbing you and a cop shows up and you say, look, man, I'm just hugging it out over here. I'm not doing anything wrong. It's like, well, yeah, we're going to go test you for, you know, meth, whatever.
Stop taking other people's crap.
All right.
Ah.
Gross. Not here for the hugs.
All right. A woman on TikTok says a TSA agent told her that people with big butts set off the X-ray machine more often than not.
Oh.
That's kind of crazy. Well, they actually said blessed posteriors, not big butts, but same thing. So here is the TikToker.
TSA agent just told me that people with blessed posteriors set off the X-ray machine more often than not. I feel like this is something we need to test out, everybody. Next time you go to the airport, please tell me, did you set off the X-ray machine?
Now, the TSA did respond. They said they cannot verify the authenticity of the claims. But what a weird thing to say. Do you ever have issues with x-ray machines or anything like that?
No.
What was your damp rid story? I was trying to remember that yesterday.
It shows up as kind of like a solid. Whatever the material is, it shows up as suspicious. And yeah. They'll empty your luggage if you're taking damp rid.
You had it in your carry-on?
We did. We don't anymore.
Yeah. Because I remember I was talking to someone that was flying, and I was like, don't put the damp rid in your carry-on.
Yeah. It does work, though. I mean, it's weird how it works.
It's witchcraft, John.
But, yeah, I don't know. They're fickle, man. I don't know. Anything can pop up. Whatever.
I've never had an ish.
Big butts I've never heard of before, though.
Yeah, me neither. But, man, some of them BBLs be getting crazy. So other people were commenting that, yeah, ever since I got my BBL, I started setting it off, and I don't know why.
My big, blessed, what is it?
The Brazilian butt lift.
Oh, gotcha. Yeah, maybe it's... It shows up as a solid. I don't like the damp rid. I don't know. My opinion is those alarms are random. I mean, I've gotten stopped randomly so many times and taken to the side, and I'm going to feel your privates. Is that okay? I'm like,
yeah, it is.
Yeah.
Do it rougher. Yeah, I feel like they're random too.
And the guy goes, and I said, was it the damp rid? He goes, no, it's your huge package.
Thanks, buddy.
The alarms are going off. All the ladies are coming over for
That's
backup.
Right.
So, weird stuff.
Yeah. We're flying in September.
Oh, yeah. That's right.
So I'm
you got the cruise coming up.
Emotionally preparing myself.
Yeah? You worried?
Well, I haven't flown in a while, and you know, Boeing hasn't been having the best of times.
Are you on a? Well, yeah, they're all Boeings.
Yeah.
I'm gonna stay off the Max 8. Cocktails coming.
But not too many cocktails, because you don't want to get kicked off. So yeah. Well, no BBLs here. I got a text in. After I lost a bunch of weight and I was too cheap to buy new clothes, my stomach set off the damn machine all the time. The TSA lady told me to buy some damn jeans that fit. So maybe it's the overfitting jeans or the too baggy jeans.
Yeah,
setting
yeah,
them
yeah,
off.
Yeah.
Hmm.
Oh.
Interesting.
Damn. Now, and then sometimes I think it's just random. It's like, okay, who knows? And maybe they're... Maybe there's some weirdos at the TSA. Who's to say?
Maybe there is.
It's an excuse.
It's weirdos everywhere.
What you got going over there, man? Nothing, just my huge crank. Oh, all right. Well, go ahead.
It's weird because that's what Christy said.
Yeah, we have got a couple of giant cranks.
Please. Coming down your smartphone. One podcast at a time. Listen, rate, and subscribe to the JJO Morning Show podcast. Get up with Johnny and D. JJO.
It is National Tattoo Day, buddy.
Welcome to the show.
Guess what?
I'm getting it.
You're getting what?
A tattoo. I'm getting a tattoo.
A tattoo?
Why is that white today?
It's National Tattoo Day.
Yeah, that's what my tramp stamp says.
Hey, that is a cool tattoo, my brother.
Yeah, I've been thinking about getting inked up with some tats.
Dude, what does my tattoo say?
Sweet!
What about mine?
Dude, what does mine say?
Sweet!
Ink tats, the coolest kind.
Happy National Tattoo Day.
Showtime.
I'm about due for a tattoo.
Yeah, I was just thinking of the same thing. It's been a while. I got one earlier this year, but
oh, did you? What'd you get?
I got my mana rays. Get some mana rays.
One that looks like it has a duck face
or stingray. Yeah. Yeah, it's weird.
No one notices but you.
I know, and then I can't stop staring at it.
Yeah,
the little head on the stingray. Yeah, I don't know why he put a little eyeball on it. That was really weird, but anyways. And get that fixed.
Yeah.
Just black it out a little bit. What's your next tat? What do you
I don't know yet. I haven't really thought about my next one. I really need to get, I need Breck from Affliction Inc. to throw more white in my JJO anniversary tattoo.
Right, your little watch, Casio watch.
My Casio watch, the white has fallen out. So I should probably just get that updated. And I'm, I don't know what's next.
I haven't.
My Knucks. I need to get my Knucks done.
It's weird. My left arm, I was all in on and knew exactly what I wanted. My right arm is just like, it's just dangling. I got to do something. I can't figure out what I want to do.
Yeah.
I don't know.
What are your...
Maybe I'll go Star Trek. I'll do a whole Star Trek slate.
Well, I mean, you like movies a lot. You know?
I could put Dole to...
Movie tributes.
Oh, Jeremiah Johnson.
I was just going to say
on my arm.
Killed the bear that killed me.
Yeah, I don't know.
Hatched
I don't know.
Jack.
I don't know. I don't know what to do. I want, if I'm uninspired, I don't chase it.
Yeah.
I'm not going to chase the dragon. I don't know what to do yet.
For sure.
I'll see where I'm at this summer and then just spontaneously do something ridiculous.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I want to get my Knucks done and I guess we'll
I'm thinking about the Knucks.
Yeah.
What are you going to put on your knuckles?
I don't know yet.
I don't either. I'm not opposed to it. The more I see it, the more I like it.
Yeah. Something silly, maybe. I don't know.
Let me see if there's some ideas.
I don't even care anymore. I really don't.
I'm sorry.
No, like, the C word, you know?
Oh. The C word?
Yeah. Then am I unemployable? I don't think I am. I saw a dude that was a server at a restaurant, and he had a neck tattoo right in the front that said, F you, the real words. And I was like, look, that dude can get a job. Who says I can't be employable with the C word on my knucks?
Good Lord.
I don't know.
That's
and then when I'm a grandma and I'm holding a baby.
Yeah, right. That's very...
It's pretty badass.
Yeah.
You know?
I'm gonna put... Yeah, this, I'm thinking about the worst C word, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or the best.
I didn't think you were thinking about cafe. or chafe or something. I don't want.
Yeah, I want to get cafe.
That's a weird one. there's some knuckle ideas. Oh, there's some great ones, man. Yeah, there's one's got homesick on it. He's got some band pictures. Man, oh, man. Deep fake, foreskin. Yeah, if you use both hands. Moisture, dumb baby, bathroom.
What? Dumb baby.
Finger me. Come on.
Finger me.
Come on.
Oh, boy. See, I like it if they're independent on each, like each hand would say something, but then you can put them together.
Well, if you roll out from your knuckles on down and just, you know. Integrate it with a something on your arm. That's a great look.
Dick hole.
Well, thank God my mom had a stroke. She can't read anything, so she's off the hook on that one.
Dick.
Okay. Yeah, this dude with knives. Yeah, all kinds of cool stuff.
No.
There's a guy that just did a ring tattoo, so you don't even have to wear a ring.
Oh, that's kind of cool.
Pretty good look.
Yeah.
Dark Lord.
Yeah, I kind of like the bands, and people have done those on their ears, too. I like the look of those. Those are pretty cool.
And some flowers. Yeah, man. Oh. And then you stack your hands. That's a good look, too, if you do this. If you
that's cool.
Stack hands.
Yeah.
Stay true. Yeah, that's pretty good. All right. It's your credo. That's your credo.
I need it.
There's Beavis and Butthead on all the knuckles.
Figure out my credo. Jeez Louise. No pressure.
I feel like none of my bad ideas are going to live up to these bad ideas. I feel like I'm being a little tame over here. So you got to do both. Would you do both or just the C word?
Well, I don't know. C hole.
And what was the motivation there again?
I don't know.
I think I missed that.
No motivation. Just throwing words out. Like, four-letter words. I need four-letter words. So it's a work in progress, clearly.
The JJO Morning Show Podcast with Johnny and D. Listen, rate, subscribe.
Catch a new show every Monday through Friday, 6 till 10 a.m. on 94.1 JJO. Or streaming anywhere in the JJO app. Johnny and D. Nowhere but JJO.